and Bree here. So, what I've learned is that sometimes you can love someone, but then again you find out that they shield you and you were too blind to see. He had me so blinded by his looks and his innocence. And I honestly believed him because I thought he would be that kind of guy I could trust. And he promised me he would never cheat on me. But I realized something. Little boys like him will can't date someone who's still act like a kid. And I told him I was going to be an adult. And he knew it, but he just took advantage of it. And thought, oh, well, she won't care because she's going to be 18. And she won't know who I'm going to talk to. But you know what? I had a feeling he was going to date me. I knew it. Every day I was so scared, and I told him, and I said I was really scared, I was really afraid, and I knew this was going to happen. But what really got me was that I remember him telling me, and he said if I ever cheated on him, I would feel really bad. Well, you don't feel bad about it now. Because you cheat on me with Ariel, and you don't feel bad about it. I was really there for you, dude. I made sure you were alright and okay. But everyone, he didn't see how much of a true woman I was. He had a good woman right here in the heart, right here. But now he lost it. He crossed the line. But you know what? He's gonna regret the day what he did. And I hope to God he learns to grow up and mature. And if he doesn't, may God have mercy on his soul. And if that boy goes to hell, I wouldn't blame him. He's not really the son of God. He cussed. He was disrespectful of God. It's just really ridiculous. It really is. And with that, it was just really messed up what he did. It was messed up what he did. I admit that. For him wanting to take advantage of me like that. Okay, I get it. There's girls my age who probably date younger guys, and, like, we just don't see what they really do. It's like they put a spell on our hearts, and they try to be a gentleman towards you. But I believe that men who are older, who are mature, can definitely respect a girl. So that's why I decided to stop dating the young ones and go for the older ones, because I was talking to a guy who was older and he had some problems up here, but at least he didn't hurt me. I mean, he was a good guy. But I had to stop talking to him because I was what? I was only 16 at the time. This guy was like in his 20s. But he was a nice guy. He's a girly like me. But he's probably with some other girl now. But you know, hey, it's done and over with, and I'm not gonna cry anymore because it was stupid to cry over him. I mean, yeah, take things to the heart. And when he broke that promise, I felt my heart shatter completely. And it was really hard. Very hard. Because he convinced me that he wasn't going to hurt me. He convinced me that he wasn't going to lie to me. He said that he would be honest, truthful, faithful, loyal. And I took that way too seriously. And he's going to put the blame on me. I didn't do anything. I'm the victim here. He's not innocent. He's not innocent whatsoever. But, you know, he's so stupid. He's being used by this girl named Ariel, and she's actually 22. He's got me blocked, so he's never going to see this video. But when he does unblock me and he gets broken up, he's going to see this video. So, Daniel, I hope you're happy. Because what you did was wrong. You had something special right here. And now you let me go. And I'm telling you, dude, that you lose a good thing right here. She ain't never coming back. And this girl is never coming back for you. I'll be out in the world talking to other guys and studying them first. So before I date any man, even if he's real or mature, I'm gonna study him. I'm going to be like that. And I'm not going to be stupid and fall for some random guy. I am learning to study about men and who they are. There's going to be that one guy for me who's going to be real with me, stay with me forever, and marry me, have a family with. And he's going to keep his word. I know he's out there. Because I know he's out there. That special someone for me is out there. But I may be single today. Getting dumped on your nephew's birthday. Not okay. So, everyone, advice. Never date someone who's going to take advantage of you. Lie to you, hurt you, make you feel like crap, bring you down, because I have confidence in myself, and I will be there for you if you need help, because I've had a really crazy life, losing my dad, my aunt. I'm watching my father die in front of me. That's just very sad. I can only think of when my dad was all happy and so full of life. And honestly, I thought my dad was going to be here forever. But you know what? He never broke his promise. My dad is still here, He's always with me. Even when I'm sad or down, so I'm not trying to cry. I remember my dad always telling me, "You'll always be my baby girl. And don't you ever go out of it." And I still have it. Still, his baby girl. I've kept that promise. Sorry, guys, I'm getting emotional. Yeah, if it weren't for my dad, I would never have been this strong. I was strong enough to survive his death, to deal with it every day. I wanted to cry so badly in front of everyone when I went to school, but I didn't. And I'm still strong to this day. And I now know that decision you gotta make. What road you wanna go down? Me? I'm going down the golden road. I don't wanna be some guy on the street. I'm not losing everything. I have hope. I love God. I love Jesus. I keep it with me. And with you guys supporting me throughout this journey, ever since last year, 2014, I've had some rude people, but haters bring you up. They build up your strength. Even if they don't like you, the fans, they give you love. They tell you that you're an awesome person, and they can be real with you. Even if you suck at selling, suck at playing anything. You guys have done everything for me, and I really appreciate everything you guys do for me. And if it weren't for you pandas out there, I would have never been on YouTube. You know what encouraged me to get on YouTube? Fans, friends, and the people who believed in me. I appreciate everything you guys do. I never had so much nice thoughts from you guys. And connecting with you guys has really helped me a lot. Even when I was upset, you guys still listened to me no matter what. Even that video I made when I was really emotional. I mean, there were a lot of dislikes because some people didn't. That was just the haters, but everybody has their opinions. And so far, I haven't been hated on as much, because you guys understand what I'm actually going through, and I really respect that. So I thank you guys for, you know, being my friends, but also my family. And I appreciate you guys so much. If you guys ever made a fan video for me, I would definitely watch it. Markiplier gets it. PewDiePie gets it. Every YouTuber does. And if I don't get an award on YouTube, that's okay. I'll still try. Or if I don't get paid. Money does not have to solve everything. It's how much grateful you are to the fans, and it's just so amazing. I mean, if you guys came up and ran up to me and said, "Oh my gosh, you're Panda Boy, I watch your videos," I would definitely give you a hug, a high five, just to show my appreciation to you, because you guys keep me up. You keep building me up every day. This is why I make videos for you guys. These videos is what I do. Thank you so much to all the 98 subscribers. If we keep making it, let's keep going. We're not giving up. We're not stopping. Keeping it real. Thank you guys for watching my channel and my videos. Thank you so much. This is too long.